Hello everyone, I am Siddharth. In this video, I will show you basic materials for the one stroke painting technique. If you don't know what is one stroke painting technique, then you can watch this video. There are 5 basic materials that you should have for the one stroke painting technique. Now I will show you these materials one by one in details. Generally, we use acrylic paint in one stroke painting technique, but you can also use oil paints, watercolors and other type of colors. We use generally acrylic paint because it is very inexpensive, it can be mixed with water, it is permanent paint. Now I will show you my acrylic paints. I have this Fabicryl acrylic colors. These are very inexpensive colors, and in India you can find these paints very easily. These are Camlin Kokuyo Fabrica acrylic colors. These are multi-surface colors, means you can paint on any surface with these colors, and these and this color are almost same. And this paint can be also used for multi-surface paint, but this is slightly better. Now this is also Camlin artistic acrylic color. Let's see. So these are the tubes. These are slightly viscous. I generally do not use these colors in one stroke painting technique. And these are Liquitex basic acrylic paints. These are good paints for one stroke painting, but these are very expensive paints. So I do not recommend these paints. Generally I use this Fabrica and this Fabicryl acrylic colors. These are excellent for the one stroke technique. These colors are very good because they are very smooth, and in one stroke technique we require very smooth paint. On the other hand, this is not good for one stroke technique because these are very thick and viscous color. So I will recommend you these color paints. Generally we use this brush in one stroke painting technique. This brush is called flat brush. This flat surface of the brush is called chisel. Brush can be small and larger based on chisel length. Generally we use number 8 and number 10 brushes for the one stroke technique, but we also use number 4 and 6 for the one stroke technique. And there are another type of brush. This is called angled brush. In this brush, the chisel is angled like this. So generally most of people use this brush, but you don't need this brush for the one stroke technique. If you want, you can use, but generally I don't use this brush. And this is round brush. We also use round brushes in one stroke paintings, but generally we do one stroke with flat brushes. In some paintings I will use these round brushes also, but if you don't have this brush, then don't worry. You will need only this flat brush, and in fact you must have number 8 or number 10 flat brush for the one stroke painting technique. I have this Faber-Castell brush. If you buy a flat brush, then make sure that its chisel should be sharp. You can see, for example, this is also a flat brush, and you can see that this chisel is not sharp. So these are 3 brushes. This brush is excellent for one stroke technique. This is good. This can be also used for one stroke technique, but you will feel some difficulties with it. But you cannot use this brush for one stroke technique. For practice, I generally use notebook papers. These are simple plain papers. And I also use chart paper or drawing paper for one stroke painting. So these are chart paper. You can find this chart paper in many type of colors. For example, this is black paper, this is pink paper, this is yellow paper. So I will recommend simple notebook papers and this chart paper for the practice purpose. And if you want to frame your painting, then you should use thick paper sheets for the acrylic paint, such as this 400 GSM acrylic canvas sheets. You should use simple paper for the practice purpose and this type of thick sheets for the practical purpose. We use a surface for mixing colors that is called mixing plate. I have not any standard mixing plate, but I have this wooden block and this plastic box. You don't need any expensive and standard surface for mixing colors. You just need any flat, smooth and white surface. And this is Son Papdi box, if you know what is Son Papdi. We also need a medium, painting medium for acrylic painting, and we use water as medium in acrylic painting because acrylic paint dries very quickly. And for acrylic paints there are other type of medium, but we don't need those expensive mediums for one stroke technique. And for watercolors we can also use water, and for oil paint we have some particular type of chemicals, but I do not recommend oil paint for one stroke technique. So in this video I have shown you what are the basic materials for the one stroke painting technique, and you should have these materials, and these are very inexpensive and cheap materials. In the next video I will show you fundamentals of one stroke technique, and from the next video we will start learning one stroke painting technique. So please watch next video also.